So today we are going to learn about Max Report Designer, specifically for dot matrix printers. So even crystal report which we have learned earlier can be printed on a dot matrix printer, but that will print little slow. The actual purpose of dot matrix printer is for fast printing, where everything gets printed in a dotted fonts. You would have seen tickets in railway station counters where they will have dot matrix printers, and the printing will come very fast. When we design in crystal report, it will be a slow printing. It's converting to an image and it is printing to the printer in a dot matrix printer. Whereas in a dot print format, it will be text which will be forwarded to the printer for faster printing. Okay. Now there are certain things which we follow for DOS printing. Assuming this is the same format which we have designed for a laser printer. See, many of these retail stores might still have DOS printers, or pharmacy chains or pharma distributors also have DOS printers. DOS printers, the advantage is they have multiple copies, the carbon copies paper. Since there's an impression of the printout, the printer prints by putting a dot on the paper. The carbon copies also get that same reflected. As per the carbon copy, it will get copied to the as many copies that are available in the hand. So generally, clients will have DOS printing for multiple copies. Original, duplicate, triplicate, all, and transport copy also, maybe four, are all punched together in a single paper. And original gets printed, remaining is coming automatically through carbon copies. So that way they save a lot of ink as well as, but it's traditional now. Slowly it is getting taken off. Everything is being replaced by the laser printers. But certain clients where this is a necessity, they don't go for any other alternate option. They look forward only for dot matrix printer for this. Now, how do we initiate with DOS printing? We have an inbuilt tool called Max Report Designer. When we go to the options configuration and go to print setup, we'll find two options here, laser or dot matrix. See, by default, we have designed one format. There are three formats here, if you can see. GST, where we have laser format, and we have a print file name, we have an export file name also, and we did not wrote any printer, and an original copy is coming in. Let's make a copy of this. I'm just copying this. Instead of GST copy, I'll just make it as dot matrix. I'm just changing the name. So we can have multiple print configurations, print settings. Maybe I can, while printing the bill itself, I can define whether it should come to a laser printer or it should get printed in the dot matrix printer. Likewise, I can have n number of print templates configured with individual voucher type. So currently voucher type is sales. In that already we have seen three are there. I'm just configuring the fourth one. Print title, let it be sales invoice, everything is same. Here the bill type says whether this print should come only for cash bill or credit bill. If it's blank, means it will be applicable for both. If we have separate format for cash bill and separate format for credit bill, then you can define two formats here, one specifically for cash. Then whenever there's a bill type cash mentioned here, the cash will be taken into consideration. If it's credit, means credit will be taken into consideration. So many of the stores will have small printing for cash retail counter and may have A4 size format for credit. So even we can distinct that way, or we can define two formats, and while printing we'll have to choose whether cash format or credit format every time. To avoid that confusion of printing or every time choosing cash and credit format, we can even link this through this build type options. We can predefine it here itself. So the credit format will not come for the cash, and cash format will not come for credit if it's mentioned. Now right now I'm just keeping it blank, so it is applicable for both. Now here I'm giving a DOS printing dot matrix. Once you just select dots, see there's a difference happening on the screen. It says print file name and design export file name is there. The print file name option goes off when you find DOS file, design, build model, and in tab space. What are these four details? See, we have even seen reverse speed and forward speed last session. What is reverse speed? Reverse speed is the number of lines that should be rolled reverse way, basically to ensure that paper comes at the cutter level. In a DOS printer, everything should come at the cutter level so that the user can quickly print, tear the printout and give it to the customer. So in order to bring it to the cutter level, you might have to do certain adjustments so that paper either additionally comes out so that the user can tear it, and then it should go reverse back in, and then printing should start. So before print startup, before the print job gets started, how many lines should it reverse, that we mentioned in the reverse speed. And then after the print job is completed and the grand total is printed, how many lines should it leave it blank so that the paper comes to a cutter level? That is the forward speed. dot matrix printer purely works on number of line count. Number of lines, generally one letter size page, that is the standard page for the dot matrix, will have 72 lines, and it might be 80 column printer or 132 column printer. What do we mean by 80 column is 80 characters, 80 alphabets. Characters basically alphanumeric, whatever it is. In DOS, everything is of a single size, similar size. The number of letters, all the fonts will be same. If you mention this is my name in the first line, there's no difference in the font. Whatever is, I mean, entire first row will be coming in the same sequence, second letter will be in the same sequence throughout the entire window. But there are certain options for changing the fonts also. We'll see that in detail now. So clear with reverse speed, forward speed. Reverse speed will be executed before the print gets started. The paper will go reverse inside. And the forward speed will be executed after the print job is completed, so that paper comes back to the cutter level. Generally, reverse and forward speed will always remain same in most of the printers. Unless if it's necessary, if it's not equally working out, then we might have to change the values as required. We can even give the values in minus. When we give reverse speed as 1, it will take as 1 reverse. But when we give it at minus 1, it will take 1 forward. Minus of reverse is forward. Okay, so minus is also being accepted. Depending on the printer, we have found certain cases where we have done this way also. That is why we have kept this all settings open here. So we have, for dot matrix printing, we are selecting dot matrix here. Reverse fit, forward fit as required. After seeing the printout, we'll have to adjust. And then, see, as we select dot matrix, we get the DOS file name. The DOS file names should also be there in the reports folder of Max ERP. Under Max ERP reports folder, you should have DOS file name. If we don't have any print format here, we can click design and start designing a new format right from the scratch. It will directly open Max Report Designer, where we can start designing a new print format. We'll see a few things here. Now, by default, it says 72 lines page length. There are certain configurations through which we can change, increase or decrease the number of lines also. If we increase the number of lines, the row height, the font length, and height will become smaller. This has to be done on the printer setting side. Standardly, this is 72 lines in all the printers. Here, there's even been mentioned 36 for the half page. Certain clients will have half page printout. Pharmacy stores and all, they'll have half page. So half would be 36 lines. So if you're designing a printing for half page, you have to mention 36. If it's full page, you have to mention 72. If it's a custom size, then you might have to define something else here as per the length of the page. Basically, 12 inches is the height of the paper. So 12, basically 6 lines per inch is the calculation. If it's a rolled paper, continuous rolled paper, many of them will have a big 5 inches roll or 6 inches rolled paper, continuous rolled paper. Any of dot matrix printers are rolled papers only, one paper will be connected to the other and tearing will happen. But in a retail counter, the paper will be much more lengthier. There's no page break happening. If there are 10 products, the printer will get over by 10 and they'll tear the paper and give it to the customer. If it's 100 products, they'll get one single big paper out and then they'll tear it there itself. If it's a roll paper, you have to take this. Otherwise, you have to take this out. Okay. Page width is by default 8.5 inches in dot matrix printer. So, in case if there's any change also, you can define the inches here. Left margin, everything in dot matrix printer is as per the number of characters which I said you. So 5 character, blank character space will be left and then the printing will start. Same way top margin is number of lines. 5 lines will be left at the top and then the printing will start. Bottom margin, 1 line. So basically from 72 lines, 5 lines is being occupied by top margin. 1 is taken by bottom margin. We only have the 66 lines to play around with them. Able to understand? And there are a few other options like ignore top margin on first page. Execute page break command after finish. So in dot matrix printer, there is even a page break command. Internal page break command means if the printing has happened in the half page, so printer will not stop there. It will completely execute. It will understand the page length. So it will execute and bring out up to 12 inches, which is 72 lines will come out and the paper will come. It will come to the cutter level automatically. Page break command is also there, but most of the times we don't give this option. Neither of the options are we enable, because by default 17 lines everything will come correctly. We measure it as per the length itself. Whatever design also we do, we ensure that it completes the 72 lines, and then the forward feed also is being taken into consideration, and then it comes to a cutter level automatically. So if we mention forward field and even the bottom margin, both will be taken into consideration. Bottom margin will be a part of the printout calculation, whereas after 17 lines, still you need few lines to be executed extra for the paper to come to the cutter level, then the forward field is being taken into consideration. Okay. But if you remain, if you ignore forward field and make it 5 lines here, then bottom margin itself becomes fixed 5 lines. Then you have, it gets reduced from this 72 lines. What else? See, we even have reverse feed forwarded again here. If you have given there also and if you have given here also, both will be taken into consideration. That one will also get executed, reverse feed. If we have 3 reverse feed there and 5 reverse feed here, 8 reverse lines will go in totally. We have kept as an independent option also. If you don't want to design there in the software, you can, if you have a report ready with everything configured in the report designer itself, then you need not configure anything there. You can directly just select the report and start it up in there. So step 1 is mentioned as report setup. Select your printer. If it's a dot matrix printer, standard font size. CPI is character per inch. Dot matrix printer, that is 12 characters per inch. By default, there's 1 inch space, you'll have 12 characters coming in. See, that's mentioned here. Note, font size 5 is largest, 10 is medium, and 15 is compressed. 5 means 5 characters per inch. 5, we have to, entire report cannot be in 5. Only the company name or some bill title we can define in 5. Because that will be just be a highlight in the printout. So we have multiple font size in dot matrix, 5, 10, 15, and 12. 12 is the standard size, 12 characters per inch. Okay, CPI means characters per inch. So in a page of 8.5 inches width, 5 inches might be for the left and the right margins, and remaining 8 inches, 8 into 12. That will be the total number of characters which can come in a single line. 72 rows, 8 inches into 12 characters. 8 into 12, almost 96. 96 alphabets can come in a single line, 96 characters. If you want more, then we can give 15. 15 characters per inch. So 15 into 8 will be almost 110 characters. And if you want little bigger size, then we can give 10 characters per inch. Only 80 alphabets characters will get printed. Print in both directions, bi-directional fast printing. What does this mean? Dot matrix printer, you'll find a header moving right and left. So by default, printer will print only once. It will print on the right, and then it will come back again. It will print on the remaining part, whatever is the line printing. When we take this, it will print on the right side also. It will, by reverse also, it will print remaining contents. By default, it's on in most of the printers. But in case if you want to improve the speed, and if it's not enabled in the printer, by software command also you can execute this. So understood about the font size in the dot matrix printers. Bidirectional printing. See, there are for certain instructions mentioned here. Printer font should be 12 CPI mode, 12 characters per inch. Line count should be 6 LPI. These are the certain settings available in the printer. By default, this is there, but if someone has changed it, we have to reverse it back to this standard so that it comes correctly. The line count should be 6 LPI, 6 lines per inch. Page length should be 12 inches. Printer font should be draft. Draft font is the one which you find is dot 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 coming in. Each alphabet will be equal. Each alphabet will occupy the same space, same height, same width. Everything will get printed in the same size. Paper tear should be disabled. This is one of the important settings. Paper tear. What do you mean by paper tear? Auto paper tear means, by default printer, if it's print, let's say 1/4 of the page is printed and the print task is completed, printer will automatically eject the page and bring it to the cutter level. Not exactly to the cutter level, but it will complete the length of the page. If it's a letter size page 12 inches, it will eject the 12 inches out and then it will wait. In that scenario, our reverse feed, forward feed, and our internal calculations are getting ignored, because automatically printer takes command of ejecting the paper. To avoid that, we will have to disable this paper tear in the printer settings. For printer settings configuration, either you will have to search in Google or you will have to contact some hardware guy or the printer's customer support, and they will give you instructions on to press certain buttons for certain seconds, and you will get all the instructions on the paper. You put a blank paper, press a button for certain seconds. It depends on printer to printer. It will print all the instructions, that to go to the menu, press this, to go to the next menu or next option, or select this option, that option. You have to press certain buttons, and the instructions will be mentioned on the printout. So different printers will have different things. Paper tear has to be disabled and printing direction should be bidirectional. This is what we are talking about, bidirectional. Both sides it should print. One half line here, while coming reverse also it should print. So then that rotation doesn't get avoided. The printing will come much more faster. So paper tear is an important setting which has to be disabled. So if the software is printing 3/4 of the page also, remaining 1/4 software should take care of executing the blank lines and bring it to the cutter level, rather than printer executing any of this. So this is one of the scenario where many of the clients are facing an issue. Paper tear is on by default in the printer and they don't disable it, and when printing comes, if it's half page or 3/4 of the page, remaining paper comes out just like that and it brings it completes there. In our internal calculation, it will leave remaining 1/4 page, it will leave blank lines in the next paper, and then it will execute the power bit command also. So that way it completely disturbs the lineup of the printout, the alignments. Till here it's all clear. The next section, section setup. Like Bristol reports, we had report header, report footer. Here also we have something called report header, minimum fixed lines. If you want fixed lines at the top of the printout on the first page, either it should be blank or it should be 10 lines at least, then you can give fixed lines. If you don't want anything, if it's 0 means by default it is suppressed only. We even have an option saying suppress. So that section itself will get ignored. Then we have page header minimum fixed lines. If we know that company name and the other billing address information is going to take 15 lines, and if we are designing content only for 4 lines, then the remaining lines, it will immediately start with the detail section. To avoid that, we can give a fixed lines of 15. So even though our content is only for 4 lines, 5 lines, it will keep the remaining lines blank, and then it will start with the detail section. So the detail section alignment comes in proper places. But if it's kept 0 means that section will get avoided. So minimum it should be 1 line. If you don't know how many lines it's going to be, then you can just keep it 1 line minimum, so that section will get visible in the design mode. Same way detail section also should be minimum 1, otherwise detail section will not be displayed. Then page footer section, minimum lines. If you have any minimum lines, okay, if you want that section, keep it 1. If you don't want the section, keep it 0. The section itself will not be displayed. Okay. Report footer again, minimum lines. Suppress blank lines in all the sections. If there are any blank lines in between, it will ignore that lines. Grouping required, again, like we saw in Bristol report session. Detail section can have a grouping for sales separately, sales products will come separately, and return products will come separately. Sales total report. We are not using all these options in such detail in Dotmatic report. What we are focused with this tool, since it's an inbuilt tool, we are just ensuring that the basic operations of the printout, the printing operations and the pre-printed formats are being met. Rather than much more conditions, if there is a lot of conditions involved, we generally design it in a Crystal report itself. Okay. So 0 section is hidden, 1 any number of lines the section can have, and 1 greater than 1 means section will remain off defined lines fixed. If you give 1 means the section can have n number of content. If the page header is 1 means it can even have 15 lines, 20 lines, as much as the content that you have defined in. But if you give a fixed lines more than 1, saying 15 or 10, even though if the content is for 20 lines, and if you give on 10 minutes, it will remain fixed to 10. Remaining of the content will ignore. Okay. So what we'll do now is, I'll just close this format, and we are not saving this. I'll see a predefined layout so that we can learn things much more faster. This first was purely settings. I wanted to explain you each and every part that was available here. What is the purpose of all these options? Now we'll see a predefined format which we have done for certain clients, and see the output of it. So either if we design it with a blank name means it's a new format, we will save that format and then we'll choose that format up from the list. It will get available here. And there are already predefined formats available here. You can see Balaji Traders and Invoice San. Let's say I give DOS PRC. That we have seen we'll see these two options also. What is bill model and what is tab space? Tab space is nothing but a left margin only. Term, it's a little different. Tab space. In Dotmatic printer, we term it as a tab space only. How much space should be there to begin? Basically, we have given we can even define this in the report as a left margin, number of characters. If we define 5 characters there, all the lines will start after 5 blank spaces. If it's not defined there, you can even define it here. For further adjustment, if you give 4 here and 5 is already there, it will take 9. It will add up both. We have certain set of predefined build models coded in the software. For example, instead of designing a format again and again or finding certain format for, let's say, a retail counter, so we have a build model saying 126, which is for GST enabled POS bill format for a small 4 inches or 3 inches PVS printer that is there. Like a thermal printer, we even have dot matrix printer coming in, small ones. So for that, we have already designed 3 inches pre-printed dot matrix format. So instead of you designing the entire report, you can even select the build model 126 and save it. So likewise, we have 100 plus models available. Some could be for pharma business, some could be for XYZ customers. We have designed a lot of formats for old customers. Before this tool was available to us, the Max Report Designer, we have been designing or we have been coding all the print formats for the customers and giving it a number for number 1 for XYZ client, number 2 for some other client, with maybe A4 half or A4 full size or some different format or thermal printer, maybe for pharma business or a steel business, depending on the type of business. We have kept on designing formats since we did not have any tool in hand, and if the client wanted fast printing, we did not have any other option, but we knew how to code it and bring it from the coding. Now after the design, this tool has got developed, we no more design any new build models. We design in the tool itself. The advantage is, once we design for one customer, the same thing, the report can be copied for other customers also, or we can make quick alterations customer and at customer side itself. But if something is coded, then we cannot make any alteration client side. If any changes are required, you'll have to request the developers to make the changes, and then again you'll have to update the software. To avoid all these continuous updates and make it more flexible, we have kept this option off. We have built this tool of dot matrix, Max Report is in the dot matrix format. So once we have DOS, and we have selected a print file name called DOS BRC, and we click design. See, generally when we click design for crystal report, it opens Max Report Designer in the drag and drop mode for the crystal report that we have seen for laser printing. And when we select a DOS printer, it will open in this format where you have a save button also at the top coming. So for the DOS BRC, already it's a half page printout, so 36 lines are already mentioned, and it's a roll paper also, it's been ticked, page width is 4 inches. All these configurations are already mentioned, top margin 2 inch, bottom margin 1 line, reverse width 1, this is the font. There's only a detail section coming in, and there's a footer section coming in, and a report header section is also there. And we click design. Once we click design, you find the sections which are having more than one line. So wherever there's a content design, it will coming in. So they have page header, they have details, and they have a report footer. See, as I select the section at the top, the content is being displayed here. We are designing section by section in this. All sections are not visible together. In page header, what all should be drag and drop. So here we again have, this is the drag and drop area where we are designing the printout formats contents. At the top, we are just selecting the section, and then we are dragging and dropping the details here. The drag and drop will work here also. Now this is a text field, so field type is text. Once you select this billing name GST, so it's a database field, and database field name is also connected here. How do we update the query in Max Report Designer for dot matrix tool? Like crystal report, we are used to connect to database and all that. That notepad used to get open. Here there is no necessity of updating the query just like that, because internally, whenever we click the design, the latest query of the software will automatically get updated, and you'll find the latest field available here. All the fields will be here. Now, in order to, let's say, we want to add something further here. It's a very simple tool. Text fields are there, database fields are there, vertical line we have, parameter field we have, and running total field also we have. We have only this PI fields, we don't have formula fields defined here. Text is nothing but we directly type something, like this particular is a text field. I want to change the alphabet caption here. Instead of particular, if I want description, I can just type here. And this has become description. Gets updated immediately. How do I insert a new field now? Let's say along with description I want something further. See, even these are lines. I have a line count, 44 is the width. We can see the information available with each and every option. I can either move using arrow marks. I can click the field and I can press up and down arrow for it to move. So automatically you can see there's some change that is happening here. The top of this has become 16. 16 is basically the 16 line. And again, once again, if I just place it here and select some other field, this gets updated. Top is 14. This description line is 15 and this is the 16. Then we have the next line 17. Everything works as per lines. If you watch it closely, you'll even find one box for each alphabet. If you can see here, it's a box available at the back. So since it's a 4-inch paper, we have the width coming up to 4 inches. And within 4 inches, how many alphabets we have? 12 CPI, so 12 into 4, 48. So we can design up to 48 alphabets. We have kept something as a left margin also, so we are defining only up to 44 alphabets, 44 characters basically, not alphabets. Can be alphanumeric, so we just term it as characters. Remaining 4 we are using it either for left margin or right margin. And what all is available with each field? Whenever you select a field, if it's text field or database field, if it's a database field, we select the database field. We can even quickly find a field if you want to change. If you want any other field, you can either quickly search and select that field. For example, I'll show you with a separate form. What all other options are available? So font can be draft or Roman. Roman is nothing but little cursive, Times New Roman font kind of thing, little stylish. Draft is basically the font which you are seeing on the screen kind of thing. It will be a dotted alphabet. Draft is the one which will come fastest. Roman will take little extra time compared to draft. What is the size? So here you are seeing multiple size, 5 characters per inch. In an inch itself, you'll only get 5 characters, which means 5 is the largest font. Then you have 10 characters per inch. This is little smaller. 12 characters per inch, it is much even further smaller. 15 characters per inch is even more smaller. 17 characters per inch also is available, which will be even further more smaller, small fonts. So maybe if we have the product name big, some description below that is required small, or some remarks is required, and that should be of little smaller font, then we can design in that way in the detail section. Or maybe the company address, if it's required in smaller fonts, then you can select the font for that particular field. By default it's 12. If you want to make it bold, you can click bold, otherwise not bold. Italic, you are able to see the differences. Underline, you are getting underline there. Immediate impact is happening. If you want a strike also, you can have strike. If you want all in uppercase, then take this while print out. All the content of this field will get uppercase. Certain clients will say all the products they want in dot matrix printing, uppercase looks much more neater. So they will say all the printout on the product name should come in uppercases. So if they are not defined in the software as uppercase, then in the printout we can select that field and click this uppercase, U case basically, all capital letters. Then alignment, whether it should be right, center or left. How does it calculate right, left, center? Based on the field width. We are giving a width option here. So this field will be only for 18 characters. 18 characters, okay. Under 18 characters, whether it should be left aligned, center aligned or right aligned. If the content in the field is more than 18 characters, means it will get truncated. If you are giving something content in the GS number, if it's more than 25, up to 18 it will print, remaining it will drop. If you want more, then you have to ensure that field width is sufficient, you know. Because since dot matrix works on calculation of the number of columns, everything has to be predefined correctly. So left position is 10. Top is 13. So on 13th line, left of 10, we start printing this content. This 18 spaces will be occupied by GST number, so this billing name GST number, as per the alignment mentioned. With center alignments, it will, after 18 space, it will still leave 3 gaps and then print again 3 gaps for the other side. It will automatically calculate all that. And if it's a number field, means you can give a formatting. Well, it should be like, it should end with double decimals or triple decimals, or if it's a date format also, you can give DDMM, YY, MM, DDYY. If you give the formatting here, as per the format, it will print out. We even have an option saying can grow here. If the content is for more than one line, should it automatically expand that row to the next line? And if that tick is on, means it will automatically expand. But the only condition for the can grow is, say, it's mentioned here. Note, font 5 is the largest, 10 is medium, 15 is compressed. Entire row field should have can grow selected if any one field has it. So if I want one field to can grow, means entire row should have can grow enabled, otherwise it will not expand. Then we have option saying subversive 0, maybe for detail section. So you can just drag and drop a new field also here. If I want one more field coming in, which I just have to click, select an existing field and click insert new field. Basically it will create a copy of it. A new field has come. Here if I want to change the field content, I can just quickly find out. Let's say I bring in mobile or email. So user email not required, billing name email is not required, shipping name email, company email I want. You can select company email here. Company email should be at least for 25 characters. So I can just select 25, I can keep it center line. And either I can use arrow keys or I can use mouse to bring it to a particular. If I want it here, I can keep it here. Wherever is required. So in this printout, if you find this build title is having font size 5. Even though it is defined here with this particular spaces, font size 5 means in 1 inch there will be only 5 alphabets coming in. So if it say credit sales invoice, then it will be big enough. It will take, credit is just 6, which is more than 1 inch. Sales invoice, it might require entire 4 inch for title itself. And then this width of 20 is in terms of size 5. This will automatically work around that way. 20 means it's not as per 12 inches. As per the 5 font size, 20 characters will be taken into consideration. You'll have to play around with this tool for a while in order to understand, because it might not come correct right in the first attempt. After the first printout, you might find some alignment changes required, and with 2 or 3 iterations, we can do it easily. At least it will avoid the developer's effort. We have this tool in place so that it can even be altered at the client side quickly. So you understood how to insert a new field. Just select an existing field and click insert, or if it's nothing is there, means you can just directly start selecting a field, and at the end you have to click insert, it will get visible on the screen. In this tool, these are the only options available: database field, text field, running total field, parameter field, and a vertical line. Why did we give a field called vertical line? I'll show you, I will come back to the detail section. Suppress if 0, suppress blank space. If I just select this, and if there's no content coming here, I can just click suppress blank space. So if it's taking 25 spaces length, and then the next field content will start after 25, if I give suppress blank space, this 25, if there's no content in that field, means it will get ignored. And the next one field, instead of starting from 26th position, will start from the position number 1 itself. In case of this email also, if I have 2 fields next to each other, let's say company GST number and email, and if I give suppress blank field for the company GST number, so currently this email will start from the position of 26. If I give suppress blank space for this field, this is starting from position number 20. If I tick this and there is no GST number mentioned, then this email will start from 20 instead of 26. If you want to remove a field, you can either right click and click remove, or you can click select the field and click delete in the keyboard. You can just press delete in the keyboard. Options are clear here. We have only one formula available here, suppress condition. For example, this wholesale price caption should not come, it's a normal text field only. It should come only for credit sales, not for cash sales. Then I can just have a suppress field condition saying, I can just find a field quickly, saying build type. Select this build type is equal to, here there is no true false condition also, it's only true one, I mean single condition. If build type is equal to credit, then only or for cash, when it should happen suppress. If build type is equal to cash, means it should suppress. I can even have some other field also here. I can just select some other database field, or I can type my own value. If build type is equal to cash, then this will not be displayed. The suppress will become true. Able to follow with the suppress condition? In suppress condition, we are not writing any code here. There's only a single option available. If this field value is equal to or not equal to something, we have all this condition here. Greater than, lesser than. If the amount is greater than this, then only something should be printed, offer message or something. otherwise it should not print. So we can select any database field here, mention a condition whether equal to, greater than, lesser than, not equal to. This is greater, lesser, I mean this condition symbol means not equal to. Not equal to, either it can be some other database field, or it can be a direct value, or it can be an amount also, 1 lakh, 50,000, 5,000, whatever. If this condition meets, means that particular field will not be visible on the printout. Clear? So we have given this condition, if bill type is equal to cash, this wholesale price will not be printed. I can just save the print report here. Then we move to the next section, details. Again we can drag and drop two things here. See, in details section we have designed two lines. First is product code, then we have product name, then we have rate, then we have quantity, and then we have basic amount. See, basic amount I have given a formatting here. 0.00, it should come. Some customers say I should not get decimals in the amount, then we can just change this. Instead of 0.0, we can just have this one. #0. This means the decimals will not be displayed. Otherwise here it will display the decimals. In second line we have kept HS in caption and the product HS in code coming here. If you want some lines coming here in between for all the rows, dot points printer generally they'll have, see there's no, if it's a pre-printed station you might have lines, but if it's a plain people, then if you want some lines coming till the bottom, then we have field for vertical line. You can just create a copy of this, change the field type to vertical line. Select, by default there's a pipe parameter coming, pipe alphabet, single line, and you can just change the width to 1. What happens in this, I can have multiple copies of this, one available after product name, then can be after product code, after the rate also, after quantity also. I can have this 4-5 times copied, you can have this copied like this, all coming in this position. I remove this fields HS and market query. If you have more than one field, you can, if you have more remarks also, you can have one more field saying remarks and type in there. We are designing only for one row, even the HS I am removing. After product name, after the rate, maybe you can have this space coming here. I'm drawing three lines here, and all these three lines are vertical line. The field type is vertical line. So what will happen is it will automatically draw till the end. If we give multi vertical line means, and if the page length is 72 or 36, and if we have only two products means, for two lines it will print that vertical line in between. And for the remaining blank lines also, it will ensure that the line gets printed, just the blank pipe. So this is what we have here, and just say this. Ensure one more thing, whenever you keep designing dot matrix tool, keep saving it every now and then. That way, in case if something goes wrong, at least everything will remain saved. You can quickly find a field from a section also. All the section related fields will be loaded here. So if you want to find a field, you can just select that particular field. So subtotal, and you can click select. So that field will get selected. Among multiple fields, you can find one field quickly among that section. Under that section, whatever fields are there, you get loaded. And that you can find out any field quickly. Okay. So that is all we have in this dot cross tool. Now the changes that we have seen, what we will see is query is getting updated automatically. I have updated this lost PRC. If you want original duplicate here, you can have the same thing again. Otherwise, you can just remove this. Let's say I have this original itself. Here again, those field, this will be dot matrix, but in case if you want to email, then this we are selecting a separate plain paper format for emailing as an export file name. Then we can route this dot matrix printer to a particular printer name. In that printer only it will print out. I can even select predefined paper size. After selecting printer, I can select a paper size of that. Then we just save this. Now when I click print here, it says GST, then I have A4 half, I even got this dot matrix here. to see a preview of dot matrix, how the output will be. I can even see a preview. This preview, it will automatically generate as per the content available in the page. Okay, this preview is coming for this, the export file format. Even a method where we can see the preview of dot matrix print out also. I'll show you that separately. Now once we click print, it will internally generate the content in a notepad format, which will be available in the temp folder. All the output will be visible. You can even see preview that way. You can go to the max folder, you can go to the temp folder, sorry, not to the tools folder. You can go to the temp folder and it will automatically create a print format saying invoice number 1. So as per the design that we have given, that wholesale caption has not come in the printout. Ganesha Nama has come, Max Enterprises have come. That wholesale format has not come. Since it's, if it's cash, means it is ready. Okay, we give condition for cash. No? That company sub caption has come in the printout. Basically, this, it just generates the entire content in text format. With all these extra lines, there's certain extra lines coming at the bottom, blank lines. So it is not going beyond this. It's not going beyond this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Some extra 8 lines have come for the paper to get ejected properly. And there's already predefined this format. This is the format where we are getting this output. If we just select some other format, options, configuration, settings. Marketing letter size plain paper. Now I get print with the dot matrix format. You see invoice number 2. Be able to see the preview only in the temp folder. We'll just see if the design was correct or not. Here the design is being for complete letter size format. It is like occupying 8 inches. Detail section is also wide enough. And I try taking a printout in that one. Since we have defined a bill model here saying 126, it is ignoring the print file name and it's taking the bill model number. So you have to keep it as a 0 and then see the changes that you have done. Now once you give a print here, preview will still come that way. Let's start printing. If you go to this folder, entire output is coming as per the plain paper stationery. As per the plain paper, all the alignments have been done and all the details are getting filled. Same way we saw that surplus condition, that was also not working only because of the bill model was predefined. We just select this bill model B as itself, loss B as. We made certain changes for the, now it's a credit bill means that line should not be printed. That is what is the condition we have given, right? Bill type is cash means. Bill type is cash means it should not be printed, since it's credit it is showing this wholesale price. Even this pipe platform, whatever we have designed, a vertical pipe. If it's more than one line, since it's a roll paper, the printing gets completed immediately when the content is over. The items are over means it will immediately start printing the summary. If it's not a roll paper, it will print this blank line one below the other till the summary comes. What I have done now is in the configuration settings, printer setup, I have just taken off the export file name just to see the preview of the output that is coming. Instead of going to the temp folder and seeing a notepad file, I can still see a preview of the entire content by removing the export file name. If I don't have any export file name, then by default when I give print and I click preview, now this is for the GST, I'll have to select the .matrix format. Once I select this .matrix format and I give preview here, it will just generate all the contents as per the format that we have selected. Basically this content itself is finally getting printed. So here if you give yes, it will start printing. But here in the preview you can see there's two gap of top margin. Then in the page header section we have all this content up to here, it's page header, up to this line. Up to this line it's page header. Then in detail section we have only one row. Then the report footer starts. And then the bottom margin at the bottom one line. So we can see output of each and every section as a preview in the dot matrix. So what content is coming where, how's the alignment, how's the output, we can verify here and then do the required changes and again see a preview. Open the contents in a notepad, use Fourier font. So we can even get this output in the notepad and then from here also we can see if it's coming directly if you want to increase the font size of this one. So this is it with Max Report Designer. Just to summarize, dot matrix printer will work as per the number of rows and columns. Generally one page will have 72 lines, which is determined as letter size page. That is the standard setting available. So half page is 36 lines, and if we have anything on a roll paper, then take this roll paper. Sections, you have to ensure it's minimum one for the section to be displayed. The detail section will always be one. If you mention the number of lines fixed, 15 lines or 10 lines, even the content is only for one line, they will still leave 10 line gap so that the alignment comes properly for us. And then we have reverse feed forward it here also, and it's there in the voucher print setup also. If both places we have mentioned means it will become, it will add both, and then we'll take that many reverse and forward. Left margin is again in terms of characters, so you can have left margin here or you can give a tab space there in the bill format, and accordingly it will take into consideration. So both places tab space as well as left margin is mentioned means it will add both and make the left margin. Same way top margin you can leave the number of lines, and bottom margin also you can define. Page width also you can define here. Ensure paper tear, which is one of the important setting, this should be disabled for the correct printer alignments and proper cutting as per. So we will have control on the cutter part and the number of blank lines to be dropped if this is disabled. In the design section, whatever sections where we have given the length more than 1, more than 0 basically, only those sections will be visible here. And here we have to select individual section and then start designing the fields there. So we have field types, what, 5 field types: database field, text field. Text is what we are directly typing, database field we are selecting from the database, and few formatting options are available. Suppress field is only for the true condition. We have a simple suppress option saying if this particular field is equal to a value or some other field or not equal to, we can give this conditions here. And if it's true means it will suppress. The true condition only has to be defined here. Same way, detail section and report footer section, you can define everything and you can keep saving the format as and when you keep designing. Predefined model is something which is already coded in the software. User cannot change anything in it. Any changes required in the predefined model numbers, we request developers to do it. Client side, it cannot be done. That is why we have this tool. So we are no more using predefined models, but we still have certain models available for old clients, so that setting is still enabled. Otherwise, we don't have any model available. Export file will be used for emailing and for print preview. Export file usually will be a crystal report file only, because that is what will be visible correctly to the customer side. That will look even more professional. Otherwise, general text, we cannot have any logos coming in the document itself. If export file is not there, and if we give preview, then we'll get a preview of the dot matrix print format itself in a separate window. So let's solve with this dot matrix window. Being rarely used, slowly it is even getting obsolete, but it's still active currently. It's not completely obsolete, and maybe in the years to come, it might get completely obsolete. But we have both this option. All the printers, laser, dot matrix, thermal, inkjet, everything is supported by Max ERP, and completely can, I mean, anything can be altered the client side by the end user itself. So seeing this video, I think anyone should be able to design dot matrix format in Max ERP. So you need to give try with couple of print formats in order to get more confidence on this. So that's all with this session. Thanks a lot.